Hey, this is Ed with AtticFoil.com. In this video, I'm going to explain why dust has virtually no effect on double-sided radiant barrier attic foil. Now, in order to explain the concern with dust, you've got to go back about 20 or 30 years ago. When radiant barrier was first developed, it was a single-sided product. They only had foil on one side, unlike the radiant barrier that we have today. What was happening is people were putting in the radiant barrier. A lot of times they were laying it out over their insulation. Dust would accumulate and they would see a decrease in the benefit. And yes, it's true. Back then, single-sided product, you get enough dust, you can eliminate or reduce the reflectivity of radiant barrier. This is why double-sided products were developed, because they work off both the reflectivity and the emissivity quality of radiant barrier. So as long as the top is clean, the radiant heat is going to hit that foil and bounce back. However, even if you get enough dust or dirt on a double-sided product, it's still going to work off the emissivity quality. Now, emissivity is the ability not to release heat in its radiant form. Now, I'm going to give you an example. This is called radiant barrier decking. It's essentially a piece of OSB or plywood decking with pure aluminum glued or laminated on one side. It's installed with the foil facing the attic, so the attic is the airspace. What happens is enough heat heats up this roof. This roof deck wants to radiate heat in all directions. Because foil or aluminum has a low emissivity, it causes it not to emit heat into the attic, but to send it upwards. And this is generally used on new construction. Now, if you take this principle even further, if you take a regular piece of foil and you put enough dust or enough dirt on there, eventually, you get this. So it doesn't matter, as long as you have an airspace on the bottom, it's going to work off that emissivity quality. In an attic application, if you lay it out on top of your insulation, what you want to do is just lay it down real gently so that you minimize the contact between the insulation and the radiant barrier foil. Generally, there's peaks and valleys on top of the insulation, so you're going to have contact of maybe 5, 10, 15%. So it doesn't matter, even if you get a lot of dust accumulate over time to reduce the reflectivity quality of the radiant barrier, the emissivity will never be affected as long as you maintain that airspace. That's why you don't want to mash that radiant barrier down into your insulation. I hope this video helped you understand the effect that dust has on radiant barrier, and to be assured that if you use a double-sided radiant barrier product from AtticFoil.com, it's going to virtually have no effect on your radiant barrier. For more information, visit AtticFoil.com, your complete online source for radiant barrier foil.